Come on, the Vidasala can't be too f- Fit.
We must hope Solas can reverse the anchor's effects before it kills you.
Hated is too smart for you, Pity, before the whole agent of Fenny business. He better help. We're owed.
Over there. That's got to be where Solas is.
With their leader woman.
Thank you.
damned mirrors has to lead out of here. Maravaskataraha!
You are dead, Inquisitor! Your soul is dust!
Ebesit kata etwa ost.
Maras kata.
Your forces have failed. Leave now and tell the Canari to trouble me no further. Solas. Should give us more time. I suspect you have questions. The
Canari answered some of those questions. The information I found while traveling through the Alluvians answered more. You're Fenharel. You're the Dread Wolf.
Well done. I was Solas first. Fenharel came later. An insult I took as a badge of pride. The Dread Wolf inspired hope in my friends, and fear in my enemies. Not unlike Inquisitor, I suppose. You also know the burden of a title that all but replaces your name.
The Dalish legends about the evil trickster god are wrong. I saw the truth in the crossroads.
You saw another story, written in desperation to give me more credit than I ever deserved.
You were a hero, Solas.
I sought to set my people free from slavery to would-be gods. I broke the chains of all who wished to join me. The false gods called me Fenharel. And when they finally went too far, I formed the veil and banished them forever. Thus, I freed the Elven people, and in so doing, destroyed their world.
How did creating the Veil destroy the world?
You saw the remains of Via Dithara. The library was intrinsically tied to the Fade, and the Veil destroyed it. There were countless other marvels, all dependent on the presence of the Fade, all destroyed. The Elven legends of immortality? All true. It was not the arrival of humans that caused them to begin aging. It was me. The Veil took everything from the elves, even themselves.
You love the Fade. Why would you create the Veil to hide it all away?
Because every alternative was worse.
Meaning?
Had I not created the Veil, the Evanuris would have destroyed the entire world.
You banished the false gods? You didn't kill them?
You met Mythol, did you not? The first of my people do not die so easily. The Evanuris are banished forever, paying the ultimate price for their misdeeds.
The Evanuris were Elven mages? How did they come to be remembered as gods?
Slowly. It started with a war. War breeds fear. Fear breeds a desire for simplicity. Good and evil, right and wrong, chains of command. After the war ended, generals became respected elders, then kings, and finally gods. The Evanuris.
You said that the Elven gods went too far. What did they do that made you move against them?
They killed Mythol. Crime for which an eternity of torment is the only fitting punishment.
I thought Mythol was one of the Evanuris.
She was the best of them. She cared for her people. She protected them. She was a voice of reason. And in their lust for power, they killed her.
That's the past. What about the future?
I lay in dark and dreaming sleep while countless wars and ages passed. I woke still weak a year before I joined you. My people fell for what I did to strike the Evanuris down. But still, some hope remains for restoration. I will save the Elven people, even if it means this world must die.
Why does this world have to die for the elves to return?
A good question, but not one I will answer. You have always shown a thoughtfulness I respected. It would be too easy to tell you too much. I am not Corypheus. I take no joy in this. But the return of my people means the end of yours. It is my fight. You should be more concerned about the Inquisition, your Inquisition. In stopping the Dragon's Breath, you have prevented an invasion by Canari forces. With luck, they will return their focus to Devinter. That should give you a few years of relative peace.
The Canari said the Inquisition was unknowingly working for agents of Fenharel.
I gave no orders.
You led us to Skyhold.
Corypheus should have died unlocking my orb. When he survived, my plans were thrown into chaos. When you survived, I saw the Inquisition as the best hope this world had of stopping him. And you needed a home. Hence, Skyhold.
You gave your orb to Corypheus?
Not directly. My agents allowed the Venatori to locate it. The orb had built up magical energy while I lay unconscious for millennia. I was not powerful enough to open it. The plan was for Corypheus to unlock it, and for the resulting explosion to kill him. Then I would claim the orb. I did not foresee a Divine Magister having learned the secret of effective immortality.
What would have happened if Corypheus had died and you'd recovered the orb?
I would have entered the Fade using the mark you now bear. Then I would have torn down the veil. As this world burned in the raw chaos, I would have restored the world of my time. The world of the elves.
If you destroyed the veil, wouldn't the false gods be freed?
I had plans.
I never thought of you as someone who would do that, Solas.
Thank you. You must understand. I awoke in a world where the veil had blocked most people's conscious connection to the Fade. It was like walking through a world of tranquil.
We aren't even people to you.
Not at first. You showed me that I was wrong. Again. That does not make what must come next any easier.
Whatever your reasons, we couldn't have defeated Corypheus without you.
Your doubts are misplaced. Everything you accomplished, you earned.
What's wrong with the Inquisition?
You created a powerful organization, and now it suffers the inevitable fate of such. Betrayal and corruption.
It's not that simple.
Do you know how I discovered the Canary plot? The plot I disrupted by leading them to your doorstep. The Canary spies in the Inquisition tripped over my spies in the Inquisition. The Elven Guard who led you to the Canary body? Who intercepted the servant with the Gatlock barrel? Mine.
Why bother disrupting the Canary plot if you're going to destroy the world regardless?
You have shown me that there is value in this world, Inquisitor. I take no joy in what I must do. Until that day comes, I would see those recovering from the breach free of the Kune.
Why?
Because I am not a monster. If they must die, I would rather they die in comfort. In any event, it is done.
I guess we owe you for that one, too.
I hope it gives your people some final peace.
You control the Illuvians now?
Yes. You remember Briala from Halam Shiral? For a time, she controlled part of the labyrinth. One of my agents was supposed to take it from her, but he did not succeed. I had to override the magic personally. The Canaries stumbled upon this section independently. With them gone, the Illuvians are now mine.
There's still the matter of the anchor. It's getting worse.
Yes. I'm sorry. And we are almost out of time. The mark will eventually kill you. Drawing you here gave me the chance to save you. At least for now.
To destroy this world. I'll prove it to you.
I would treasure the chance to be wrong once again, my friend. Take my hand. I'm sorry. Live well, while time remains.
Something must be done, but we cannot lose the Inquisition now. We stand on the brink of war with the Canary.
Yes, because this Solas provoked them in the first place.
We apologize for not informing the summit beforehand. We were concerned.
Of course you were! The Canary spies were inside your organization!
Without our organization, none of us would be here to complain.
No one has forgotten what you have done. But Corypheus is 2 years dead.
If the Inquisition is to continue, it must do so as a legitimate organization, not a glorified mercenary band.
Inquisitor.
You all know what this is. A writ from Divine Justinia, authorizing the formation of the Inquisition. We pledge to close the breach, find those responsible, and restore order, with or without anyone's approval. I'm proud to say we accomplished that goal. We will honor the sacrifices of those who gave their lives in defense of what we stood for, and still stand for. Because our work is not done. Where we led in war, we will now serve in peace. The Inquisition will act as Divine Victoria's personal honor guard. Answering directly to her, we will transition from a military force into a peacekeeping organization. My own adventuring days may be done, but the Inquisition and its mission will continue.
Thank you.
My agents have found nothing. With the Illuvians, he could be anywhere.
Maintaining the Inquisition, even as a peacekeeping force, leaves us vulnerable to agents of the Dread Wolf.
But also gives us the strength to respond.
We will need to be careful.
Solas knows everything about us. Who we are, how we work, our strengths, and weaknesses.
Then we find people he doesn't know. We will save our friend from himself, if we can.
We'll be right back.